Get ready for Ultimate Adventure 2022 presented by Rugged Ridge. The staff, cronies, invited readers, and sponsors pile into 26 off-road rigs that range from wicked street-legal rock buggies to fairly mild-mannered IFS Toyotas. This year, we're back in the Southeast, where last time it rained the entire event, like gather two of every animal kind of rain. With better weather this time around, UA's got super scenic drives like Tale of the Dragon, awesome side trips like an abandoned, haunted prison, camping, camaraderie, field fixes, and of course, some of the craziest wheeling the Southeast has to offer. Whoa! Including Hawk Pride, Windrock, Colmont, and one or two places you may not have even heard about. It's time for Ultimate Adventure 2022, presented by Rugged Ridge. So be sure to catch all five full-length episodes to enjoy all the action.
Well, welcome to day one of Ultimate Adventure. We are headed to the Hawk Pride Off-Road Park in Tuscumbia, Alabama. It's a private park that's set up for four-wheeling and side-by-sides. A great place. It has hundreds of trails. You know, we're gonna just get a little bit of a taste of the park because we're only gonna be there for a day, but I guarantee you, it's gonna be a good taste.
We've got a little bit of everything this year. You don't really expect to see a full-size van or maybe an M715 or a full-bodied Ford. We have Jeeps, we have Toyotas, we've got a little bit of everything on UA this year.
Hey everybody, UA 22 land. We're back at the Southeast. Last time we were in the Southeast, it rained every single day except for one morning. And that morning we were in canoes splashing each other. So today we've got some good weather, a slight chance of rain. Can't wait to hit the trail.
Pretty good storm sail coming through, I would say within the next 30 minutes. So it's gonna get sloppy for sure.
Well, it was clear blue and sunny when we left the hotel 40 minutes later. We're hunkered down in a pretty good sized rainstorm. So we're hoping it blows through pretty quick. Probably pause the group here for just a few minutes, let the worst of this blow over, and then we're gonna do some four-wheeling. But the cool part is, it's gonna make the trails just that much cooler.
It wasn't that bad. Come on down, Roscoe.
Dry and dusty day today. Everybody should hydrate so that don't get dried out. What do they say? Hydrate, moisturize, don't fall down. I think those are the rules of Ultimate Adventure.
I brought a 2021 Toyota Tacoma. It's got 38-inch Milestars on it, RCVs in the front, custom 9-inch in the rear, custom rear suspension, custom bed. It's a pretty fun little toy, and we're really gonna try it. See how it works through all these different environments this week. I come from a rock crawling background and I've always had straight axle trucks, and this does not flex as well as straight axle truck would, but it's got a lot more travel than you would expect, and it rides really nice and is super stable. So we'll see how it performs throughout the week.
So Tiger, he landed on that ledge and it snapped. The dry shaft hit, twisted it in two. Put on a good show though. It's quite entertaining, which he always is. And to see a van in here, it's even better. It's going to get slick and more slick as the trail goes on and as the group comes forward. Starting off excellent.
That's actually the first trail I've ever had this thing on, so I'm happy it's going.
all good. South in this kind of weather, it's all about throttle and momentum. And some of these guys, you know, it's going to be new to them. And a gas pedal, especially if those guys that wheel out west, you want to stay away from that because that brake stuff or whatever. But out here, that's pretty much what you got to have to have.
Pretty happy with the way the Ultimate Shop Truck's working. I have the truck; it was free, had a salvage title. So I felt kind of like I was bringing something back from the dead.
Extreme parking, 2022, or thing.
I think I was talking to Harry Wagner and we kind of fell into this theme of like the kind of early 80s Toyota truck. They're all on leaf springs with solid axles. So I was like, oh, I'll do that. And paint matches that. It's from 1983 in the sticker package as well. So I just wanted to keep everything simple. That's what works out here and goes down the road well.
So we're still on uphill both ways. This is about midway point. We have a large rock you have to pivot around using your various body parts, rockers, doors, fenders, bumpers. There is a go around, but a lot of guys are choosing to follow the leader, which is awesome.
Oh, let me see what I'm looking at here. Look at that, we saved the door! Yay!
The obstacle looks easy. I don't know what it's taking everybody so long. All you gotta do is slam your driver's side rocker into the rock and let her eat.
Seen an elephant sneeze? Well, it's called elephant snot, and that's what it's like. So it's slick. The nice thing is it's sandstone rock stuff, so if you get the mud off of it, it still grips. But when you get a big obstacle, you'll be hearing some horsepower today.
If you're ever off-roading in a Jeep and you rip the mirror off, you just get one of these, Mirror Master Pro. It's biodegradable. Stick that in there, and then you put the mirror right back on there, just like new.
Where can you find one of those?
You can find Mirror Master Pro at mirrormasterpro.com. And if you use the offer code FRED, you get 52% off. But there's no free shipping. We're not doing that anymore. That was a waste of money, giving away free shipping.
So we just finished the first trail of the day, which was uphill both ways. We're gonna go a little bit further down and then take a left up Merlin. It's a creek bed. Starts out with smaller rocks and then at the end they become boulders. And with the mud and the rain, this may be the last trail of the day.
This ain't my first time.
Okay.
I'm already ahead of you.
I know how you get when you don't eat, man.
I know.
I don't want you to get low blood sugar and start.
We have rear diff hung up on rocks, not wanting to pull off of those rocks, so we're gonna use this stuff and use a tree for the rear diff off of the rocks. Not our favorite tool.
I just wanted to drive. I'm not doing a very good job apparently because we had to pull cable for the first time today, but other than that, that's fine. Maybe I'll get the hang of it.
Bobby Summers from Chino Valley, Arizona. Here with my 1988 Toyota 4Runner. People are kind of going nuts, this IFS, but show them what it can do, I guess. Let's see. As far as the build goes, it's a Total Chaos Caddy 2 long travel kit. The rear is a custom Deaver pack. It's dual locked, ARB up front, e-locker in the rear, dual cases, two gear drive 228 cases. It's got all the low range it needs. It's a 3RZ swap rather than the 22RE. It's got a cage, bed cage. It does everything very good. I'm very happy with the build. I think I need a little bit bigger tires. I was diffed up too bad. Pull the line. I don't want to hold everyone up all day, so I think I could sit here and work at it, maybe get through. Just a lot of diff rocks, the little tires, so we're gonna hook up to this tree and get going.
He was winching and it lost all power in the vehicle, which this is not the winch running the battery down. He lost either a relay or tripped a relay. But we've got no power whatsoever.
I think I got it. It's just the breaker in there is popping, so I'm just going to eliminate the breaker and put it straight to the battery.
Okay. Bobby had a breaker on, which is the right thing to do. He had a breaker on the main power. His battery's actually behind the seat. And unfortunately, the breaker just wasn't big enough for the winch. The winch under peak load will pull better 400 amps or whatever, and it was only a 150 amp breaker. So, and it sounds like he may have just broken the CV.
The side that's broken in, that can stay, right?
Yeah.
And then the other side, I can zip out and just get it out of there. So,
okay, yeah, pull the shaft.
Is it bolts or is it?
It's
like
just bolts.
Oh, okay.
I mean, six bolts.
I think the best thing to do, Bobby, is we'll get it pulled and we'll probably run you out this way. And that way, it's a nice, good road up there. So, I don't know why we're messing around in this creek. It was a perfectly good road right there.
Yeah, the stub shaft just kind of broke clean, so yanked her out and gonna drag her out of here, I guess. Basically wheeling up a creek bed with a lot of big rocks and trees in the middle. You pick your line and then everything goes out the window, your tires start moving and the whole vehicle's jockeying, so you're kind of going in an uphill toboggan ride. It's really enjoyable.
Excited to be here. Looking forward to the trail, a little nervous, but we drove the rig 2,400 miles to be here, so we think it's pretty sorted out, and we're just happy to be part of the adventure. Started building rigs like 6-7 years ago when I discovered the ultimate adventure and started applying. I have two that are built to specification and have applied a total of 9 times, and made Dirty Dozen back in 2018, and then was blessed to be here this year. So it's been a journey, and we're excited to be here.
Thank you.
I'm trying to learn how to drive my Jeep that I just finished a week ago. Oh, there it goes. Say hi, you're on camera.
Your freedom top gives you the freedom to explore.
Yes, thank you. This is Noob Sock, not to be confused with my old Jeep, Tube Sock. It's a 2018 Jeep JL Wrangler. It's a little two-door, which is actually getting kind of rare to find as two-door Wranglers these days. Everybody seems to be getting the big four-doors. It's got a new engine, tranny, transfer case, Dana 44s, so I'm only running a 37, but I'm running the Falcons. It has electric lockers, front and rear, some custom suspension stuff, a worn winch, and we're having some really good rock crawling.
How the South welcomes full-size rigs to the trail.
My name is Matt Anderson. I'm a reader of Four Wheel Magazine. Brought a 77 F250 this year to UA. It's got a 5.0 Mustang motor out of a 92LX. It's got a 203 205 doubler, 2003 Super Duty axles with 538 gears, air lockers front and rear, three linked in the front and four linked in the rear with Skyjacker suspension, worn winch, and Falcon tires rocking it, and yeah, it's doing great, having a good time.
Managed to wrinkle up a little bit of sheet metal. I kind of knew that was coming. I may have wrinkled a bit more than I expected to on the first day.
Day one, UA 2022 at Hot Pride here is done. All that's left to do is get back to the hotel and make some repairs. We put some battle scars in some of the rigs, gave the new guys a look into what UA is all about, gave the veterans a little bit of a warm up. We're gonna get back, make our repairs, fuel up, and get ready to hit the road tomorrow.
Next time on Ultimate Adventure 2022, presented by Rugged Ridge, we have a long road day ahead of us and cross the state line. But that doesn't mean there won't be plenty of dirt under the tires. We're headed somewhere steeped in racing history and an epic campsite for our first camp night. And then charging straight into some more wheeling you won't want to miss.
This is my favorite kind of wheeling. Like coming to the South, getting in the mud, and bouncing off these rocks is where it's at.